Democracy Now!, democracynow.org, The War and Peace Report. I'm Amy Goodman with Sharif Abdelkaddous.
Thousands of events are being held worldwide to mark the 100th anniversary of International Women's Day. A handful of European countries first marked the day in 1911 following a declaration by the Socialist Party of America. The United Nations has recognized March 8th as International Women's Day since 1975. International Women's Day celebrates ordinary women who have played an extraordinary role in the history of their countries and communities. It's also a time to reflect on the progress made for women's rights and to call for change. And it's a time to call attention to a number of issues facing women, including discriminatory laws, the high rate of pregnancy-related deaths, and the disproportionately high number of women killed and victimized by wars.
Here in the United States, the focus includes the Republican-led campaign against women's reproductive rights, the comparatively heavier burden of poverty on women, high domestic violence and maternal mortality rates, and the disparity between men and women in available employment and wages. Joining here in New York is Kavita Ramdas. She served as president and CEO of the Global Fund for Women from 1996 to 2010, currently senior advisor at the fund and visiting scholar at Stanford University. Welcome to Democracy Now!, Kavita Ramdas. On this 100th anniversary of International Women's Day, would you share with us the history?
Yes. Well, I was sharing with a friend yesterday who said, oh, do you know it's International Women's Day? And I said, yes. And do you know that we should be standing in solidarity with the workers in Wisconsin? And she said, what do the two have to do with each other? And I said, everything.